Hey, it's me, Melanie, the book boss lady. It's me, Melanie, the book boss lady. It's me, Melanie, the book boss lady. Hey, it's me, Melanie, the book boss lady. Where we're talking about books, business, being a boss, and everything in between. That's right, I said everything in between. But tonight, we are going to talk about how to sell out at a book signing. Woo! If you are an author or an aspiring author, you want to get your pen, you want to get your pad. I promise you, there is some information you do not want to miss on tonight. So get ready, get ready, get ready. Hey, Kim, how are you? Welcome, welcome, welcome. You ready to sell out, Kim? So, yes. Hey, instructor Mike, how are you? Welcome, welcome, welcome. We got celebrities in the house. Hey, so I'm super excited. Because I had a book signing, right? And I sold out today. So I was like, what better thing to talk about than how to sell out at a book signing? So there are some, I would say, some tips and some strategies that I use and things that I want to do. So if you're ready to sell out, put in the comment section, I am ready. Right, I'm ready. And so, again, we're not going to be on here before you long, but I do want to talk about some of the things I do in order to sell out. Now, I'm going to give you a few basic things in the beginning, and then we're going to get into the meat. And so, a lot of people think some things are basic, but they're really not. So, the first thing we are going to do is we're going to smile. Smile, right? When you're at a book signing, when you're at a place where there's lots of people, you want to look inviting. You know, if you're a woman, make sure your hair look nice and cute. Make sure, you know, you look presentable because you will draw more people onto you when you have a certain look. They say people don't judge a book by its cover, but they really do. So people, I had so many compliments the past 3 days on my book signing. Oh, you look so nice. And it drew them to my table. So you want to draw people to you. However, you know, with your appearance, with your smile, but the first one is smile. Yes, Kim. Hey, Anita, you ready, Anita, to sell out at these book signings? So smile. And the second one is small talk. Talk to everyone. Lottie dottie, everybody. So when I have a table at a book signing or anyway, I don't let people pass my table. Now, if I'm in the middle of a conversation, I'm not going to stop in a conversation and talk to someone else, right? But I don't let other people pass my table. So that means if someone comes to my table, if someone comes or try to walk past me, hey, how you doing? Come over and take a look. Do you like to read? I have certain questions that I ask and I let people know, you know, but I don't prejudge. So that's one thing. I need you to make sure you get a hold of this. Never prejudge anyone. They may not look like they may not read your book. They may not even look like they speak English. They may look like they speak Spanish. They may look like they speak Asian, Chinese, or Vietnamese, or whatever. Never prejudge. You may say, oh, this person is older. They may not like my book. But guess what? You never know. So never prejudge. I talk to Lottie Dottie, everybody that comes by my table. You would be surprised. Even some people, I've had people say they don't even look like the type to buy your book. It doesn't matter because if they're not, once I finish talking to them, they usually are. They're like, oh, yeah, I need this type of inspiration. Even if they're not a Christian, even if they're not like a Muslim guy bought my book today. Okay. Yes, Instructor Mike, he said that is true. That is one of the most important things a person can do is think that your books will automatically draw. Oh, no. Yes, it's your personality and how you look. That's right, Instructor Mike. Yes, we have to draw, draw, draw. Like I said, I get compliments all day long. And they're like, oh, and I'm like, well, come on over and take a look at my book. So it's like you have to draw, 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 draw. So, yes, hey Linda, welcome, welcome, welcome. So that's it. Never prejudge, draw, draw people, smile, draw the people, small talk with them. Hello, act like you're interested in them too. Now, number two, I give a small discount. So, my books on the cover of my 90-day daily devotionals, they may say, $14.99. So when people say, how much are your books? I say they're normally $14.99, but today they're on special for only $12. So people want to sell. How many of you want to sell? Look, be honest. You want to sell? Put yes in the comment section. Everybody always want everything on sale, right? And so I have them thinking that they're really getting a sale. And then not only do I have them thinking they're getting a sale, but number three is I sell in bundles, right? So I sell bundles. You're not just going to get one book from me. You're going to get two, three, four. Just about everyone that comes to my table, they buy multiple books, sometimes two of the same ones. One lady said, I'm going to get this for me and I'm going to get this for my daughter. So I always recommend giving them as a gift. Also, who do you know that has a birthday coming up around the holidays? And of course, it's a holiday almost every month. But right now, we just had Father's Day, right? We have people graduating from college right now. Before that, we have Mother's Day in May. There's always an opportunity to let people know, hey, who do you know that has a birthday coming up? Who do you want to celebrate? Who do you know that likes to read? Who do you know that likes daily devotionals? So I always ask the question so that they could get more, and more, right? We don't want to just sell one book to one person. The goal is always to sell multiple books. So if you have 10 people that buy from you that day, you can sell 10 books or you can sell 40 books. If you have 100 books on you, say you bought 100 books to that book signing event, right? Again, you have 20 people to come up to your table. If you sell 5 books to each 20 people, you have sold out. But if you only sold one book to each person, then you're going to have a lot more work to do. So the key is, again, yes, Anita. Yes, Kim Bright. That, amen. That's right. Thank you, Kim. Yes, that's good. You want to always sell multiple books to each person. Again, never, ever, ever just sell one. I mean, and you may have one person, oh, I don't have anybody to get it. And, you know, sometimes you have a sister, my sister don't like me. So again, you know, but most of the time, I would say even the past 3 days, majority, 90% of the people who purchase books from me, they purchase multiple books. And one lady was like, oh, I want 3 separate bags. She bought 3 books, you know, 3 separate bags because I'm giving these gifts out tonight, right? So they already know people they want to give gifts to. So that's another way you can sell out when you are at a book signing. I want you to think about some of the opportunities you have for book signings. I want you to think about some of the people that you talk to. So the next strategy is always let them know that you are going to autograph their book. So a lot of people get this. Oh, can I go to Amazon and purchase it? Oh, is your book on Amazon? And when you say yes, some of them are like, oh, I'll purchase it on Amazon later. Mm-mm. The way to combat that is you say, well, if you go to Amazon, you don't get my autograph. And they're like, oh my goodness, I do love autograph books. And so it like flips the switch like right then and there. Always let people know you're going to autograph their book for them, right? And when you autograph their book for them, I'm telling you, it is on like popcorn. Now, if you like what you're hearing so far, please, please, please make sure you give me a thumbs up. Make sure you like the broadcast and make sure you subscribe if you haven't already done so. And join our membership. Now, next week, we're going to have a members only chat. And the only people that's going to be able to chat are the people that's a part of our membership. If you're ready to be a book boss, make sure you join our membership. And so, yes. So make sure you, yes, that's good, Instructor Mike. Yes. And the price is higher. And some people say, oh, well, I have Amazon Prime, so I don't have to pay for shipping. So I used to say the price is higher and you have to pay for shipping. So now I just say, yes, the price is higher. You won't get the discount. right on purpose. So when they look on Amazon, they will see right the actual price and that she wasn't lying. Absolutely. That's right, Mike. So that's another strategy that I use. And I let them know that they don't get my autograph and that the price is higher because they're getting the discount. So let me go back to the bundle deals real quick. I'm going to give you an example of the bundle deal. So if I say, okay, well, it's normally $14.99, but today it's on special for only $12, or you can get two for $22. And sometimes I'll say three for $33 and four for $44. They're not even really getting the discount, but because I say four for $44, I mean, two for 22 and three for 33 and four for 44 are the same price, right? They're all $11. But they're like, oh, I'll get four for 44. And so I sold four books to one person. So yesterday I sold out of my Women in Business book. And then today I sold out of my other two books, Daily Dose of Declarations and Daily Dose of Determination. I always give people sometimes that say, oh, I'll be back, or I'm going to the restroom and I'll come back, or let me go shopping first. And so I don't have to carry it around. So I have these nice little cute bags. That's another thing I have, very, very nice. Now, I have had people purchase my books because they wanted to get the bags. So I have some really cute bags. Now, I do have a video and under book marketing tips on my playlist that actually will show you the bags that I use. I actually did a video on how I package my bags before, but how I package my books before I ship them off. So you definitely want to take a look at that, because I'm telling you, people love my bags. And that's why I say, the lady was like, no, I want three. I want one for each book. She was like, I want a separate bag for each book. But they, even gentlemen, usually it's, I thought it was a woman thing, but lately I've been even getting a lot of men like, oh, that bag is so cute. I want that for my wife. And so, you know, she likes flashy things like that, or she likes, so make sure you have nice bags. Make sure you have nice things to put them in, because like I said, people see them on my table. And when they see those bags on my table, like, oh, can I get a bag with that? The other thing is, today was a reminder also, nice bookmarks. I get people ask me all the time, can I get a bookmark? You get a bookmark if you purchase a book. It comes with it. Yes, you don't have to pay for it. It comes with the book. And so you want to have nice bags and you want to have nice bookmarks. Yes, Kim. Yes, that was good. Instructor Mike. Y'all go follow Instructor Mike. He has 19 children's books. Yes, yes, yes. And he also, in addition to the 19 children's books, he has his Instructor Mike, where he gives concealed to carry. He gonna correct me in a minute. courses that he does. And so you want to definitely follow his Author Mike YouTube channel also. But yes, you are right. Females love cute and glamorous things. That's right, Kim. They really do. They love cute and glamorous things. Look, Instructor Mike said, that's not a bad idea, right? Four for 44. He said, hey, come on, somebody. You do. You have, 19 books? So you can say eight for 88. Oh, he got 20 books now. So he going to say 20 for $200. Now that might be a bit much. But when we talk about when Christmas is coming up and we talk about Black Friday, because we're going to have an event where we're going to help you with your Black Friday sales so that you can really maximize it and really make this Black Friday one of your best Black Fridays ever, selling your products and services. And so, yes, that is not a bad idea. Four for 44 and eight for 88. Yes, sir, Instructor Mike. That's how we go make it happen. We are going to sell in bundles, and we're going to sell, like I said, I get people all the time, four for 44, four for 44. I've only had two people catch it. They was like, four for 44. That's not really a discount if I get three for 33 or two for 22. And his wife was like, just go ahead and get the books. It's so funny. I'm telling you, sometimes you have the wife really usually wants it. Usually the men are like, come on, you know, and the lady would be like, I have to come back without him. So it really just depends. Again, you don't want to prejudge. You want to talk to everybody, whether it's a couple, whether it's together. Yes, 20 books now. Awesome. Okay, Instructor Mike say I'm fine. Right, because I don't know. Hey, Angelica Truth the Fish. True the Fish. How are you? What is his name? Author Mike. Isn't it is your children's channel is Author Mike, right? But if you go to his Instructor Mike YouTube channel, he actually has his featured channel and it says Author Mike. So if he don't tell you what it is, you could just go to Instructor Mike and look under his featured channels. He is a YouTube boss, y'all. He almost have 100,000 subscribers on his Instructor Mike page. I'm telling you, he's making it happen. And so, yes, Instructor Mike, book sets. That's what I'm talking about. This is why you want to have a series. And this is why I have the Daily Dose series, because I am going to put it like the four box book sets. But it's so much bigger than that. Getting ready for Black Friday, you don't want to just have the book sets. We don't, oh man, you're going to be ready. I'm telling you. So it is so much money in books. People don't think it's a whole lot of money in books. If you do it right, it is. Don't be playing on your phone. When you're on your phone and you're going to be looking down, people are walking by. And that's why I be getting people text me a lot of times during my book signings. People be trying to call me. I do not spend a whole lot of time on the phone. I may take a little 15-minute break and get some water and get a snack, and then I'll respond to some of my text messages. But no, while I'm at a book signing, that is not the time to be talking to people I already know. That's not the time to be talking to people that already have your book. Put your phone down when you are at your book signing. The only reason why you need to have your phone is if you taking them credit card payments, you swiping it, or you sticking the chip in the chip reader. Hello, somebody. That is the only time you need to be using your phone when you are at your book signing. So people may think, oh man, hours went by and she didn't even respond. No, because I'm handling my business. I'm about my business and I am making sales, or I'm talking to a potential customer, or I'm talking to someone that wants to buy my books. And so it's, people like, how do you sell so much? I mean, sometimes it's like, soon as I'm in the door, I'm selling. Because again, as they walking by, as they, hi, how you doing? Come on over, take a look at my books. Hi, how you doing? Do you like to read? Does your mother like to read? Does your wife like to read? Does your sister like to read? But you want to make sure you are definitely communicating. You want to have engaging conversations with them. You want to smile and be engaging. So yes, hey, True the Fish. And so, oh, you're publishing two new books this month. Congratulations, Angelica. I'm so excited for you. Yes. Let's go. Let's do these book signings. I'm telling you, I love it. Again, people think, oh, you don't know. I make money at my book signings. And like I say, I sell out, not taking any books home. That's right. Author Mike and Friends. So his name and his YouTube channel for his author channel is called Author Mike and Friends. So make sure you go subscribe to his Author Mike and Friends channel. And I started by saying, you are the truth. That's right. I'm the truth. I do not be playing. That's why they call me the book boss lady. Okay. It's time to boss up. It's time to make it happen. And so let me give you another example. Sometimes you, oh, okay, write this down too. Make a goal. Make a goal. Make a goal, you're gonna sell out. Make a goal, you're gonna make $500 in one day. Make a goal. And whatever your goal is, do not leave until you finish that goal. So my goal was to sell out today. So I had to stop to do a conference call. I did a silver presentation for one of my team members. I told her I would do it. So I took a little break and did that. Now, as a result, it took me a little bit longer to get my goals. So instead of leaving at 4 o'clock or 4:30, I end up not being able to leave till like 5:15, because I was not leaving till I met my goal. And one of the ladies was that came back to get some books. And she was like, oh, you're packing up. I said, oh, I wasn't leaving until you came back and got your books. And until I sold all my books, she was like, oh, thank you so much for holding my books. Because she was one of the people saying, I'm going in the store. And when I come back out, I'm going to get your books. But she was gone for like 3 hours, y'all. But again, never underestimate. I've had people say, oh, I want to get one for everybody in my Bible group or my book club. And they'll buy 10 books or 20 books at a time. That's like Mike, when he said 8 for $88, really, there are people that, because they will buy, okay, I want to get, one lady, she was like, oh, I need to go to the car, because she got my new book, which is bigger than 365 days. She said, well, I'm going to get a few, and I'm going to go take them in the car, and then I'm going to come back, and I'm going to get some more. And so, yes, yes, yes. If Kim say yes, she is. I am the truth. Look, handling my business. Yes, about my father's business. So basically, those are some of the strategies I wanted to share today. Again, I told y'all I wasn't going to be on here long because I have been going. When I say I've been moving and shaking all day, I have been moving. After my book signing, I had a time to get something to eat, and then I did another presentation, and then I'm here on my YouTube live tonight. And so again, make sure you give me a thumbs up if you have not already done so. Make sure you share, because sharing is caring. Who do you know that's an author that need to be selling out on all of their books, right? And so definitely join us in our membership. We look forward to having you be a part of our membership. But we're going to get ready to wrap up. So if you don't have any questions or anything else for me, he said it flows off the tongue. That's right. 8 for $88. It sure does. It flow. I love it. No, really, because it became such a habit, Instructor Mike. Matter of fact, I'm going to go back to that for a minute, because you don't want to sound like a robot. You want to sound like it flows. You want to just sound natural. And it's like 2 for $22, 3 for $33, or 4 for $44. And before they know it, they say 4 for $44. And so, yes. Hey, Lillian. Welcome. Yes, I forgot one other thing. I'm glad you said that, Instructor Mike. It flows off the tongue. Hey, Lil. So what happens is you want to make sure you give them payment options also. When you give people payment options, you will sell more books. Don't just take cash. You want to take cash. Matter of fact, I'm going to start taking Apple Pay and Google Pay too, because someone asked me today that I take Apple Pay. And so I said, no, but I do take, you know, credit cards, and I take, because I was at the base, I also took Military Star. So before, when I didn't take Military Star, I missed out on a lot of sales at the base. So if you are going to be selling at any of the bases, then you need to make sure they set you up where you can take Military Star, because I get checks in the mail from them. Matter of fact, I need to switch over where I'm getting direct deposit, but I get checks in the mail from them all the time from people paying with Military Star. That's right. 4 for $44 and 8 for $88. Just let it roll off. Come on, Instructor Mike. Yes. Any 4 for $44. Any 8 for $88. Instructor Mike, he got it down packed now. He was like, let me get this right. Yes, Lil, Zelle too, right? Take Zelle. Again, take the payment options, okay? You can have Zelle can be connected to your business banking account so that it is going into your business account for your books. And so, again, the money is available. Make sure you have your payment options. PayPal has a chip reader. Square has a chip reader where you could take their cards. If you do punch in the numbers and you don't have the chip reader, they usually take a larger percentage. But most people do not carry cash on them anymore. And because they don't carry cash, you want to make sure you have options to take their credit card payments. Okay. Now, I am not an advocate for taking Cash App. Now, if that's the only alternative, I don't want you to leave any money on the table. Y'all know how I am about leaving money on the table. No leaving money on the table, right? We grabbing all that money from the table. So as a result of not leaving any money on the table, I need to make sure you have different payment options. So, but Cash App really is not legal for business entities to take it unless you have the business Cash App. Why? One, Uncle Sam want to get his money. So if you don't have the business Cash App, the personal Cash App, they don't send you a 1099 at the end of the year. Another reason why you don't want to take Cash App, especially if you're selling online or on like Facebook or social media or places like that, because if they don't give you their address, you don't know where to send the book. It's not as easy to put in information or even respond to the person sending you money on Cash App. It's not like email where you can email them back and say, how do I send you the book? Where do I send you the book? I love Square's tracking system. When people order, it says you have a new order. It automatically push a button to send them a message saying their books are being shipped to them. You could even add the tracking number. I love, love, love how easy it is when people place order for books through the Square app that I have, the Square that I have. And I can even the app on my phone, I can click on it and just say, yes, your book has been shipped. And so you want to make it easy to take payments. You want to make sure you're not leaving any money on the table. All right, we're going to get ready to wrap up. Does anybody have any questions before we wrap up? All right. Well, thank you. Thank you. I told Instructor Mike he should be a comedian too. So Instructor Mike says Cash App in the hood is good. I've mastered Cash. We'll have that discussion. We're going to have a discussion about that. Okay, Instructor Mike. Instructor Mike said he has mastered, and a lot of people, I've mastered Cash App too, but Cash App was designed for you to send money back to your friend, back and forth to your friends and family, because Cash App is actually owned by Square. Did you all know that? Cash App is owned by Square. Cash App was created to compete with PayPal because people were sending money back to their friends and family via PayPal. And Square was initially only set up for businesses. So they created Cash App. They were like, oh, we're missing out on some money, right? So they created Cash App to say, okay, this is an easy way through an app. You can send money to your friends and family. It was never intended for you to be taking payments for your business courses and your books, Instructor Mike. He's laughing at me. We'll talk about that. My pleasure, Kim. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for y'all. Make sure y'all go follow Kim. Make sure y'all go follow Lil. Everybody here has a YouTube channel. I'm not sure. I know Anita has one. Linda K. Lee. I think the only one that doesn't have one. Do you actually do videos on your YouTube channel, Angelica? True the Fish. I don't know if you do YouTube videos. So, all right. Well, with that said, I'm so glad you joined me on today. Again, if you have not already done so, give me a thumbs up, like, subscribe, and share, because sharing is caring. Y'all know who this is. It's me, Melanie, the book boss lady. It's me, Melanie, the book boss lady. It's me, Melanie, the book boss lady. I'll see y'all later. Bye.